Simon Panraka, that's me. Simon Panraka, Simon Panraka. Hello, my name is Simon Panraka. Simon Panraka, Simon Panraka. Hello, my name is Simon Panraka. Other Simons just act amateur, major's damager, cramming in the clamor to be the biggest fan of the one true man of the first name Simon, last name Panraka. I don't know if I told you my name. I'll probably play it safe and maybe say it again. I've just got one, don't you call me no other, 'cause my name is Simon Panraka.
Simon Panraka, that's me. Hello. So this one is about the future. And obviously, the thing about the future is that you can't know what it is. I'm just gonna take the echo off.
Yeah, it's quite futuristic though, maybe I'll leave it.
The thing about the... The thing about the future!
Future!
Is that you can never know how it will be. For example, the next word that I might say could be the most exciting word ever. Boggle. I found back there. So anyway, I couldn't figure out what I thought that the future would be like. So basically, I asked my nieces to tell me their ideas. Because child labor is easy, and it's a good way of not having to do as much work. So this is a video of my nieces talking about the future and stuff, and then we did a little impression of what each part, what thing they said would be like. Thanks!
Hello. My name's Poppy, and this is my sister Flo. So Flo, what do you think the future will be like? Because I think that somewhere around this earth there are monsters. So then I think that everyone will like have a monster and they'll use magic to keep them in their garden.
Monsters for sale. They can do excellent tricks like breathe fire. And they can breathe water. Totally lovable.
Get your monster pet today.
Well, there's people who can fly in the sky. Their houses are flying too.
Come on, little monster. Why don't we go to float to Jenny Polo's house?
Why did you have to set it on fire? Quick, we're getting out of here.
No more visits for you until you think about your behaviour.
No. I think that like the parks might be like this pod or something, and you walk into it and it has like this, those buttons that have like pictures on, and then like you click a button and then the pod goes up on stilts and then you like click slide and the slide comes out.
First people might start no pressing buttons because you know what that leads to. Should we have the stilts yet? Going up. Then let's do the slide. We're gonna go down it. No, little monster! That's over.
If you like wanted a trampoline, there could be a trampoline button, and then out pops the trampoline from like the bush or hedge. It's like your garden is completely empty.
Why did she beckon to?
Oh, little monster, I was jumping on that. Do you mind?
People will like have this special brain thing, so then they just attach a cord to their brain and then they know everything.
Time for some learning.
I know everything.
The weather that will be like in the future, whatever you wish it happens. But if one person wishes for sun and one person wishes for snow, it would just be cut down the middle.
I think that my plants need to have some hot sun to burn them so they grow into a luscious tree. Sun, come.
Those poor little frazzled leaves. You need some rain. Rain, come. You're looking much better now. Rain always does the trick.
Oh, it's not working. Maybe I need to be struck by lightning. Lightning!
My beautiful little plant's burning! Oh!
So that's what we think the future will be like. What's your theory?
I hope they come true. Today, maybe, when we're gone. I don't know what would happen in those places. Bye!
They're beautiful kids, huh? Yeah, I wanted to make a video with them where they built a robot out of cardboard boxes, but it didn't come to life. But then they got a couple of AA batteries and just dropped them in. And then I would be a robot and do a dance with them and stuff. But man, they were just like, oh, I want to be a robot dog and all this shit. So I couldn't do it. So we made that instead. But it's nice, isn't it? It's nice to let them have more fun than I did that day. obviously in the future there's going to be robots. Because we all know that is true. There are almost robots now, but they just make cars, which is bullshit. Because they could be like stroking your head while you fall asleep. And stuff like that. So I decided to make a robot beard hat. Because robots should have beards, I think, in the future. Because if they're going to be like humans, human beings, even old ladies have beards. Let's play a video.
Hello, I'm Simon. And today I'm going to show you how to make a robot beard hat. It's going to look like this. Pretty good, right? You will need a sieve, a bendy spoon, heart lights, two handles, mini sieves, a lot of scourers, wire, tape, and scissors. I was thinking the sieve could be the hat part because it's already hat-like and we'll just stick things to it to create more of a robot beard hat. First of all, I'm going to start with this bent spoon to create a kind of nose piece, similar to a Viking helmet. If you haven't seen the last video about how to make a watermelon Viking helmet, check it out, it's similar. I'm going to thread the wire through so I know where to do it, but ow, ow. As you can see, I've bound round the spoon, and now I have this attractive nose piece here. Let's see if it fits. There we go, that even helps keep the hat on. So now I'm going to add the horns, which are these door handles. Oh no, I've done it wrong. The kids next door are very noisy, aren't they? But it's fine because they're having fun, and sometimes it's nice to have fun. But I can be noisy as well. It's looking pretty good. I've got it going round and round here, round and round through there, and then up and down at the back. It's pretty secure. And you can do that. Pretty patterns there. If only we were making dainty patterns. But we're not, we're making a robot beard hat. No room for loops. Unless they're beat loops, robotic. Like, like that sort of loops is fine, but we don't want wiry loops, so get rid of them. Okay, let's continue. It's looking pretty sweet. Got the two handle horns, horny handles. That even, maybe this one is to go backwards in time. This one is to go future in time. What I'm gonna do is bend the handles of the spoons so that they fit nice and snugly. Whoa. Yeah, pretty strong, right? Oh, this sure takes a long time and I do find it boring to do this kind of stuff. I wish that there was some way that I could see how it would look when it was finished. Maybe in the future, it will have time traveling properties when it's done. And I can see, come back and travel in time and say, hey Simon, yes, so what it's gonna look like, just keep going man, persevere. It takes a long time and you might cut your finger, but it's pretty sweet, I think you'll agree. So carry on, good luck, bye. Wow, it looks amazing. Now I feel really invigorated to finish the rest of the hat. Thanks very much, bye. Bye. What a great guy, let's carry on. Just looping it round and round. So I guess I was wrong about the wire loops, because I am indeed using wire loops, ticketing ticketa, 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 wire loops, ticketing ticketa. Because it's going to look amazing. I'm going to leave the hearts for now, because that's like for to figure out for when I go out with this hat at night time. So I'm getting the wire here and putting it through off center to give us more beard hanging down, you see? So I'll just do that, thread them all on. I drew blood. Oh, be careful with the beards, guys. They're sharp. It didn't hurt very much though. I'm not gonna cry or anything. Gonna made a beard helmet, and now I'm gonna put it on and be a bearded robot beard hat. Bearded robot. Here we go. Hello, I'm a robot with a beard. Now I can go back in time and show you Simon how it looks like in the past. Let's go. Hey, Simon. Yes, so what it's gonna look like. Just keep going, man. Persevere. It takes a long time and you might cut your finger, but it's pretty sweet. I think you'll agree. So carry on. Good luck. Bye. Wow, it looks amazing. Now I feel really invigorated to finish the rest of the hat. Thanks very much, bye. Bye. Whoa, it's future me with the eyes fixed. Hello, dear, look, come and have a look. Just gaffered them in a little bit. And now I got glow in the dark eyes. See you then, bye. Bye, bye. So there you have it. Why not try getting all these things from your local fancy goods store and just make a robot beard hat, and maybe send me a picture to simon@simonpanrucker.com or facebook.com/simonpanrucker or Twitter is @spanrucker. And I look forward to seeing your robot beard hats pictures. Have a nice time in the past or the future, wherever you're from. I love you very much. Goodbye, beard. Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep.
Thanks. So that's how you can make a robot beard hat. I have got the robot beard hat here today. Do you think I should put it on? I don't know. Do you think I should put it on? Okay. Hello, I'm a robot and I got a beard. So let's do some songs about the future. I need your help. Do you have any ideas for a song title based on the future that I can make for you right now wearing this beard hat, robot beard hat? Falling Over is Banned. Okay. Yeah, any more? Cryogenically Frozen. That sounds cool. Good, these are great.
Proven good for your health.
What's that?
Okay.
That's the great thing about quantize. It's if you play really badly, it's just an unpredictable, fun rhythm. So this is good. When I was 27, I had the thought, yeah, I didn't want to be caught short in my lifetime. I wanted to have more fun until the end came. The end didn't want to come because I thought I want to live forever. So I got my head severed, put in an ice cube and put into a freezer. I thought, geez, this is real sweet for me because I want to live in the future.
Yeah, so I can tutor all the people in that time what the past was like. And they'd be like, hey, this guy's real tight. His knowledge is phenomenal. How does he know all this historical stuff? It's really impressive. And
chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears sieves. It is the future, we're all robots. Everybody do it and just show off. Yeah, chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears a sieve.
Yeah, we're all robots. Everybody do it and just show off.
Yeah, chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears a sieve.
Everybody do it and just show off, come on.
Chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears a sieve.
It is the future, we're all robots. Everybody do it and just show off, yeah.
Chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears a sieve.
Yeah. So before too long the novelty wore off. Everybody thought I was nothing better than a trouser cock, because I was too stupid by their terms. There was way more things I had to learn, because in the future, didn't you know that falling over's illegal? Just goes to show that health and safety is run amok. It's a PC world gone mad. What the fuck? And also, what was the other one? Okay. Yeah, I was like, man, cut that smoking. Everybody's like, hey, you gotta be joking. Don't you know that this shit's good for your health? I was like, well, I must be off the shelf on the end of shelf life, because my brain's in a different era. But yo, I'm a hero because I took the bravery test and now I'm in the future. Yes, yes.
Chop my head off, I put it in a fridge. Blah, blah, blah.
And just show us, everybody do it and just show off.
And chop my head off and put it in a fridge. Going in the future where everyone wears sieves.
We're robots. Everybody do it and just show off, come on.
Chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears sieves.
Just show off, yeah.
Chop my head off and put it in a fridge. I wanna go to the future where everyone wears a sieve.
It's the future, we're all robots. Everybody do it and just and just show off, yeah. So basically, I'm gonna play a short documentary video. I wanna talk smack about it, but I think I'll just play it. And then I'll talk smack about it afterwards.
Today, I found in the bottom of a drawer in my desk, two disposable cameras that I have never developed. One of them looks like this, and the other one of them looks like this. So today I'm gonna get them developed and see what's on them, and see, compare from when back then I was in the present, but now I'm in the future to myself then, which is the past to me. Okay, let's ask people what they think. It might be on the cameras. What do you think might be on it? What might have taken
No idea.
Probably blurry things.
There's some of a park.
You've been out and about with your friends and take lots of photographs of them, because boys of that age, that's silly.
Like posing, mostly like that.
Yeah.
You on the beach?
Something to do with a beach, maybe? I don't know.
An old animal that's trapped inside a rock.
It looked like a princess.
I think there's a monster in there.
What did you say?
A monster.
A monster? Oh no! Hi. Let's get it developed. Okay, so here we are now at Photographique, which is Bristol's premier independent photo lab. I'm gonna talk with Hamish. Hi, Hamish.
Hi, that's me.
I just looked at the number on this one, and actually it says there's 24 remaining pictures. Okay. Did I even take any photos on this one?
I can just check that for you. No, I don't think you did.
Oh.
This one's still got six remaining images. Or...
Do we need to use them up?
Yeah, potentially.
Okay. We need to use up 5 photos, so let's go and do that now. Let's find some willing photographers. Here's picture number 1. Thank you.
That's strange.
That's it. Yeah, it is weird, isn't it? I'm not even sure what we're doing. Okay, here's photo number 2. What was your name?
Julie.
Thanks, Julie. Lovely, thanks very much. Great. Go for it, Oscar. Okay, that's photo number 3. Thanks very much. It's the end of the film. Okay, Hamish, we just got some strangers to take photos of us. How long will it take to develop this?
We can do it in half an hour.
Half an hour, really? So we can get it back today?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, let's go, come back in half an hour. Thanks, Hamish. Ooh, okay, here we are. It's more current than I thought. These are photos from university. This is Paul. They are making a sexy pose. Martin, classic Martin pose. So rude. Oh, that's me with no facial hair and some spots, even at the age of 21. This was at New Year's Eve in Brighton. It's a happy time. I feel a little bit let down because I thought that it was going to be nice childhood photos, and it's basically like a few years ago and just a party, and that's what happens now. So it's just like looking at Facebook or whatever. Don't think that anything's changed in my life, just going to parties and doing that same stuff. So I can kind of guess that in the future, probably be doing that as well.
There you go. You can see why I want to talk badly about it, because like, imagine what that could have been if the camera held some amazing lost memories. Just think about what could have been. But you can't dwell on things like that, because... So guys, I'd like you to welcome onto the stage Andrei Sosnovsky. Andrei is a good pal of mine, and he just recently we collaborate and we make films together. What do we call ourselves?
The Fabulous Pooh Brothers.
The Fabulous Pooh Brothers. Hooray!
So the other day Andre and I started doing stand-up comedy together, so we'd like to do it for you now, if you don't mind.
Thanks for not giving me a mic.
Don't ever touch that again. Stand-up comedy. There is a future-themed short that we shot the other day, isn't that right?
right, now shut the fuck up. There's no time. These are the rules, so just listen, okay?
When the portal opens up, you gotta walk through it backwards, but you gotta be facing forwards.
When you go through the portal, you gotta make 3 small steps. But if you end up making more, just don't worry about it. Once you're on the other side, there are gonna be 3 more portals. You can use the 3rd from the left middle one, from the 2nd one from the left. But make sure you use the right one. I mean, not the right one, but you know. Pull the lever 12 times to reverse the clock, or 2 times to deaccelerate it. If your hat is a tiny bit tilted, it will add 4 hours. But you don't even have a hat, so I guess there won't be a lever. There will be a button though, but don't press it. You gotta believe everything I say. But if I'm doing this, don't. Apart from that, if I'm the last person you've seen today, look away right now. Great! I think you're ready. Okay, let's do this. Yes, yes. Oh. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
I guess I have to do one more improvised song. Does anyone have another suggestion? Everything's the same. Okay. Okay. I thought it would be cooler, but nothing's changed. There's still politicians ruining everything, and all these pop stars singing, but it's all crap, and I don't know. I thought the future would be like, yo, this shit's beautiful, but it's not, it's the same. Everything is boring, and my life's draining away. It's boring. Don't like it, it's boring. Food prices are high unless you get shit, but then that makes you die because it's full of salt and sugar and things that clog your arteries. We're on a fast track to heart disease, and all of my friends talking about me behind my back, it never ends, because I guess I still do bad things, and that's okay, because everything's the same, nothing's different. I thought it would be different, but it just isn't. I'm sick of this place, it's really, really dull. It's just like being in Hull.
Come on, it's the future fashion. If you got some fashion, come up now. It's the future fashion time. All right, is it just one person? Yeah, come up here. Talk us through what you got here, Rich. What's going on? Who's your designer?
Okay, my designer is Couple of One.
Very good. What's going on this side?
This is an AppleSoft propaganda portal. Apple and Microsoft have merged and taken over the world.
Wait, it's got like some squares on here like Microsoft does, and it's got an Apple on here like Apple does. Show it around. Bleep, bloop, bleep, bloop, bleep. Amazing. And what about this side?
This is a graphing glove, and this powers everything from my AppleSoft devices to my artificial appendix.
Can you hold it up proud for everyone to see? To the untrained eye, it would look like a sock with a smashed CD glued to it. But it's actually, what is it?
It's a graphing glove. You'll learn about it soon enough.
Give it up for Rich, this is amazing. Is there anyone else anything to display? No? Then you have won a prize. I don't know what, but you will love it. Here is the next video, which is called Psychic something something.
This is the final chapter of the Psychic Vision Quest compact disc. Now you will combine all the techniques you have practiced to trigger a deep vision during which you will learn your ultimate destiny. Move into breathing method 2 now. Give your diaphragm plenty of support to fully oxidize your transmental psychooptic nerves. Move into breathing method 3, cosmic cry. Use your vocal cords to vibrate in harmony with the galaxy. Time.
Explode? That's stupid.
Thus concludes the Psychic Vision Quest compact disc. For information on future releases, well, you know that already, don't you?
And this is a friend of mine called Simon Matthews. He lives down my street, and his mum sends him over when she gets frustrated with him because he's a bit of a handful. We only practiced this song today, so I don't know how it's going to go, but let's give it a go.
Okay, just give me 5 minutes. I told you I got to talk on a video to Simon Panracker.
Simon.
Oh gosh, he's so annoying.
Simon, hello.
Hi Simon.
How's it going?
Hi the Golden Lion.
Hey, you okay?
If you're having fun, make some noise. Wow, you guys must be having a great time.
What's
lucky
up with you?
For you?
What's wrong, man?
Well, I just got grounded again, didn't I? For something that isn't even my fault, so I can't even be there again.
What did you do this time?
Well, today it was the careers advice thing, and the careers advice lady was asking me all these hard questions, like, what do you think you might want to be when you're older, like in the future and that, and yeah. I was just saying, like, How can I possibly know what the future's even going to be like, let alone what sort of thing I might want to be? It's an impossible question. Why have you only got like five options, like boring jobs that I don't even want to do? Because basically, in the future, it could be anything happens. And so she didn't agree with me, and basically, I chucked a table through the window.
Why?
Well, I just thought that it was to prove a point, really, because after I'd done it, I said to her, well, you didn't see that happening, did you? So how can you know exactly what the future's going to be like? Well, she didn't find it very funny or clever, and she said that, and then I've got grounded for a flipping whole week, haven't I? So I can't do anything.
Well, we made
a... I'm dressing up as a trucker, because I actually think I might want to be like an interstellar trucker, like a galactic truck driver. If that exists in the future, it might. So that's what I'm working towards at the moment. But anyway.
Well, do you know we did that song today about it? Do you want to play that?
Do you want to do, yeah, let's do the song. Can you just play the guitar this time and not sing? Because I found it a bit distracting last time.
Yeah, that's fine, because okay. I don't know the words.
Let's start the song then. It's called When I Grow Up by Simon Matthews and Simon Panraker. Here we go. When I grow up, I don't know what to be. It could be anything, cause no one really knows what the future brings. So why should I decide right now? Doesn't make any sense. When I grow up, there might be loads of robots who can do the stuff that we don't want to do, so enough's enough. Cause I don't want a job where I end up hating it. I'd rather fly a spaceship as I sing. La 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 la. When I grow up, there could be many jobs that aren't invented yet. So maybe I don't want to be a dentist or a vet, or a person stacking shelves in the shop. Oh gosh, it's so boring. When I grow up, I want to be a dinosaur with power saws, or a laser-powered truck that can transform into a giant sword that can smash through asteroids. Or perhaps I'll be an android that sings bleep bleep blue bleep blue bleep 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 bleep. Why do I have to choose what I would like to do when no one has a clue what the future holds? It could be anything. Why bother limiting our options to the things we know of? Cause nobody can tell what the future brings. It's so exciting, nobody can tell what the future brings. So why make it boring? I could be a scuba diving astronaut, or maybe build a bridge up to the moon, but nobody will even let me have the thought, cause they've decided what to be too soon. Like idiots, it's stupid. When I grow up, I don't know what to be, but it could be anything.
I fucked up the last chord, sorry everyone. Bye, Simon! Guys.
Just remember, the future's not decided, so you can do whatever you want and just follow your heart and your dreams and sometimes your mind, but not very often. And then you can probably just achieve the stars, the limit of the moon. So just keep aiming for the galaxy, and every time you miss the moon, you'll land inside a black hole in the sky, which is cool. So okay, I gotta go to bed now. Maybe I'll see you next time, unless I get grounded again. Okay, bye guys.
See you later. Bye. Thank you very much for coming. Thanks very much. Find me on the internet, simonpanraker.com, facebook.com/simonpanraker, Twitter is @spanraker. Come and say hello and let's have some fun. And I love you very much. Thank you for coming and have a safe journey. Bye!